with Missouri Mudders. Getting ready to go down to one of our favorite parks, Carter's Off-Road Park. Really excited. For once, we're not having to work an event.
Yes, I'm super excited. I cannot wait for this weekend.
We love going down here. We were down here in, I think it was March for Carterfest. And then this is called Mud Daze. This park is almost like our 401k. I'm telling you, all we do is come down and just take money back home to Missouri with us. So no matter what Arkansas Jeff tries to say, all you have to do is watch the video to see. We pretty much win everything. On a side note, I did hear a little birdie told me that Mr. AKA Bryce Has Too Much Money Sparks is going to be coming down for this event. So I'm looking forward to having like a little, I guess what would you call it, a pre-sequel to our event coming up at Pike. So I'll probably hold off on the machine just a little bit. I don't think I need to go full throttle to beat Bryce down here, but we'll see. I'm not going to lie, I'm a little concerned with this buggy being a bounty course machine. His machine is definitely meant for bounty courses, where mine's a little bit more of a mud machine, so we'll just have to see how it goes, but we're going to have a great time. Unfortunately, I know Anthony, Tate, and Larry, Dreadbone Oaks, and Donnie, and Trey, and Chris, and all them, they were going to try to come, but they're not going to be able to make it, so that stinks. But we've got John's coming down to defend his title from STL Power Sports, John the Jet Connorsman, and Sexy Santa, myself, Christina Collins, Steve King, who finished, I believe, 7th in the Stage 1 Bounty Hill. We've got a bunch of Missouri Mudders going down right now. The river's finally down. My gosh, it's went down 10 foot in the last day.
They're cleaning up the debris.
But we'll do some video on the way down, and obviously we'll do some video while we're there. We have our own Laura Mama Bear Hopner and Kyle Fireball Hepner that's going to be coming down with us, so we can't wait to see those guys. And yeah, just a big group of us going down, and we should dominate like we always do, so I'm pretty excited. What do you think, babe?
Oh, I can't wait. The weather's going to be so much better. Last time we were down here, it was snowpocalypse.
That's right.
It was a blizzard, literally.
Right.
This time, it's supposed to be 92 and just hot, and I prefer the heat. Bring it on. Super excited. Can't wait. Favorite trails. Love the party spot at the river. I'm sure we'll be in there a lot since it's going to be hot.
I'm not going to lie. I was a little disappointed that Bam Slam did their $85,000 event, so I'm sure a lot of the heavy hitters are going to be going to Alabama, especially on the East Coast side. But I've heard a lot of Texas boys are still coming to Carter's. We love to compete against the best. I love competing against Byron Starrett, as you guys know. I mean, he's my hero. I always look up to everything that he does. He's just such a great driver. He's even a better person, but he's the best driver in the world when it comes to this stuff. And just by watching his videos, you can learn a ton. So I want to give Byron a big shout out. Tell him I'll try to represent and do him proud. And other than that, like I said, we'll do some video. Hopefully, we have a good, safe trip down there. We're going to meet up with Mr. Steve King and do a little convoy down there. And then everybody else is kind of coming from different directions at different times. I think most people are coming down tomorrow. But other than that, stay tuned and thanks for watching.
You know, the mud man can't go anywhere without getting recognized. It's the good looks, the flowing blonde hair, and the good looks.
Eat your heart out, Bryce.
Yeah.
That's what it looked like if you were a 10 out of 10. Well, Father Craig's here. Just wanted to punch him in the nutsack because he said Bryce Sparks is going to beat me in our race in June. So, hey, yeah, yeah.
The nutsack's fine. It's not the knee.
Yeah. I love him so much, I'm going to let him get away with that one. We're heading down to Arkansas. Got Steve King, Steve Jr. here, looking to kick some ass. A great shirt, by the way. Steve finished 7th in the Stage 1, didn't you, Steve?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, and it, from what I've been hearing, you're planning on doing a little bit more to the machine.
Yep.
It's the never ending. You just get to the point where we're at where then you start up and it blows up when you back it off the trailer.
Buggies are looking good.
Yeah.
Got both loaded up here.
Yeah, that green looks great on that red.
It does.
Yes or no? I mean, the only thing that's sad is we're not taking this guy down with this.
That is sad.
Yeah.
Hard to get vacation time when you're off 3 months for knee surgery.
This is true.
Is that what happened when you're old?
That's what happens
when we're old. Right. That's what I mean.
When I'm double your age.
I don't think that, but God bless if you are.
Okay, we'll take it.
We'll take it.
It's hard being 28. That's all I know. but other than that, this is basically where we're going to start at and head down. We'll do a couple videos on the way. And as usual, we'll probably pass Father Craig somewhere in Arkansas or somewhere on Papa.
Never know.
We'll pass you all the time on 141.
Good luck.
Stay tuned. Making pretty good time. Weather's hot. A good old munching pump. There's officers, our convoy people. How's it going?
Good.
Everything great. Going well?
Smooth sailing.
That's what I thought. Smooth sailing. See Josh working hard to clean the windshield for me. Any words on our travels?
No, the trip's going well. Been on the phone pretty much the whole time with Mr. Magic Modder Entertainment, Corey Rager, and Sexy Santa James Mabry. It's actually been pretty smooth right down. We're at the Arkansas-Missouri State Line Center here. We always seem to get gas here. Barely made it. The only thing they have is 87 octane, so I don't have an 87 machine. I don't know ever, so we'll see how that works. I think Steve can say the same over here in this nice Ford. I don't know if it's ever seen.
Probably some bad gas mileage we're about to get. Worse than we're already getting. Buggy looks nice. He brought some extra tires.
Smart man. Mud tires and bounty horn tires. You know me, I'm too lazy. I got brand new tires in the garage. I've just got to convince some damn lazy to bring tires. And I sat down here, thought Cheryl was going to spam me. I was going to bring the tires. I just said screw it again.
This sounds like deja vu.
I know. I hate changing tires. And to me, if you're a good enough driver, hell, Byron Star Rack can win without tires. So that's where I'm trying to get in my life. It doesn't matter about the tires. Just give me a set of mud tires and I'll start rock crawling with them. But
we'll make it work.
It does make a difference having the right tires for some of these. I can't believe on the turn burn last, 2 or 3 months ago down here with mud tires. So we may try it again. We may not even do the turn burn this time. We may just try to save the machine for the bounty hole and the bounty course. But I don't know. We'll just see what happens.
Checking everything, making sure it's all nice and tight.
Make sure it's not falling off.
Are those brand new tires?
These last winter, these are really low bad tires.
Oh, they're so clean.
These ain't holding up.
Looking good for sure. A little bit of an issue coming down here. Sweet Spot RV Rental, Mike called us a couple times. They're just awesome. First of all, if you need to rent an RV anywhere down here, call Sweet Spot RV Rental. We rented 4 spots down here and 3 RVs, and Mike was pulling our RVs in this morning and someone was in one of our spots. Spot 2 was already taken. We think maybe it was somebody who just took the wrong spot too, but they weren't there. They had dropped the camper off and left and were in some town.
I said Conway, which I think is like an hour and a half away.
Yeah, so they're in the wrong spot anyway, but they've got a hold of them and they're coming back to get out of our spot. But Mike from Sweet Spot had to deal with all that today when he was just trying to drop off campers for us. So we appreciate all they're doing. Yeah. They are just a great company, so convenient.
But they definitely make it easy for sure.
So we appreciate everything Mike did for us today. Thank you.
And here's the ride up to the park. Like I said, you're hardly ever going to end up riding into a park where it's you're passing horse stables and, you know, big lakes, and you get right into a park. It's
beautiful.
The coolest entrance I've ever seen in my life. Right, mud park for sure.
As they're trying to keep everybody's speed down with the speed limit radar here.
See, we had so many bugs coming down here. I'm going to clean the windshield twice.
Yeah, and it is pretty buggy.
It's like we never cleaned it the first time.
Very nice subdivision right here next to the park. I don't know how they feel about all this.
I bet they hate every second of it, especially event weekends.
I mean, they are right next to the park. These people right here, their backyards. You can see this house.
Oh, yeah. You are not loving Carter's Off-Road Park if you are not into off-roading.
Because they're open every weekend.
Yeah, 365 days a year, I believe. I don't think they ever close. Oh, such a fun park. I'm really excited.
It is. Somebody asked me today why it was my favorite park. And I said, number one, because of the trails. The trails here are just awesome. They are muddy and watery, but not to the point where you can't make it, but you can get stuck if you want.
Well, stock machine can just about go anywhere. There's some holes off to the side if you want to go in. If you want to go in down by the, I can never remember the name of it, the shallows, the
Oh, yeah, I can't think of the name of them. I can't think of them right now either, but kind of by the castle.
Yeah,
they do have cool places to stay with the treehouse cabins, the castles, the little A-frames up at the top. So that's cool. They have Sweet Spot that delivers RVs out here for you. So convenient. It's just a great place.
Hey, appreciate it.
Okay, so here we are coming into the park. This is the vendor area. Looks like they have more vendors because usually they don't have people over here. They just have them over there to the right. So that's kind of nice.
Monster Ricky. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. There's more. I wonder if Ginger is going to be here.
Mm-hmm. I thought Hillbilly Shack was too.
I thought they said Bricks.
Oh, Bricks.
Okay, so here we are coming into the VIP camping spots.
Right behind the vendors area.
Yeah, vendors are right there.
Oh, they're up here already hooking it up and getting out of here.
Wow, well, they got here pretty quick.
Mm-hmm.
This is our three.
Here's our RV from the Sweet Spot. It's pretty nice in here.
This little fireplace, don't think we'll be using that. Here's our bedroom. Here's the back bunk room. Pretty nice little camper.
Ooh, I like Hunch Punch. Okay, look, we are here.
I like them on my KM, I don't know. First time I caught them on here.
We're just kind of hanging out for a minute, getting situated. Got us a nice RV, nice spot. Friends are arriving.
Yeah, I agree. So,
and we're about to get some food first and then probably headed to swimming hole.
I thought I'd give it a break before.
Here we go on our first ride. We're going to go to the swimming hole.
Thank you.
Tiffany and Josh.
Oh, sorry. My bad.
Oh, wait. We just ran into Tiffany and Josh from Arkansas. A couple people that we love to death, so stay tuned.
Yeah.
These are really, really deep.
I think you went the wrong way.
Yeah. Let me get a pair. Let me get a pair. Hey, we got World Youth Test.
Yay. Get the girls in the bag.
Hey,
Sheriff.
Hey,
Sheriff.
He's trying to come down here. Sure.
We got another one.
That's bad.
A lot of people on this little ride.
Well, that's why I kept looking back.